The best choice is C, choroidal fissure cyst. The key image including a cystic lesion in the medial right temporal lobe. You can see on flare the signal looks clean and it's bright on T2, so you should follow CSF signal intensity in all sequences. On flare, you also see no abnormal signal surrounding the cyst, so there's no evidence of gliosis or acute parenchymal edema. There's no enhancement. So everything we see so far has a benign imaging characteristic, and this is what choroidal fissure cyst should be, benign. The diagnosis is made based on the location. Choroidal fissure is typically sitting above the hippocampus. In some cases, when it gets large enough, like in this case, you can actually appreciate mild mass effect on the hippocampus. But notice that the hippocampus itself has a normal signal, and even though it's mildly compressed, it retains the intact internal architecture and it remains normal in volume, so there's no atrophy. So what is a choroidal fissure cyst, or what is a choroidal fissure? Choroidal fissure is a C-shaped cliff that serves as the attachment point for choriplexus. It's located between thalamus and the fornix. At the level of the temporal horn, you can see in this diagram, laterally in temporal horn, there is choriplexus, and the medial aspect of the hippocampus, that's fimbria. So the choroidal fissure is the attachment point for the choriplexus. So typically it's sitting above or superior medial to the fimbria, and it's sitting between the hippocampus and the adjacent thalamus. You can also view choroidal fissure as the far lateral extension of the ambient cistern. So choroidal fissure cyst usually is incidental, typically very small. And the differential diagnosis is made based on the typical location, which is within the choroidal fissure and typically is sitting above the hippocampus. It is not based on histological content. In other words, choroidal fissure cyst may represent a neuroepithelial cyst or arachnoid cyst. If it gets large enough, it may compress on the hippocampus called symptom. Uncommonly, you can see case report that the large choroidal fissure cyst presented with seizure. So let's look at other answers that do not work as well in this case. For example, choice A, epidermoid cyst. This is a good example of epidermoid cyst. On T2, epidermoid cyst is bright. However, on flare, there's incomplete fluid suppression. Unlike choroidal fissure cyst, that should follow CSF signal intensity in all sequences. Classically, epidermoid cyst also shows restricted diffusion, where, of course, choroidal fissure should not. Choice B, ganglioglioma. So when you look at the lesion, you may think that this could represent a cystic neoplasm. However, on T1 weighted sequence or post contrast, you see there's absolutely no enhancement or no enhancing mirror nodule. Contrast that to other neoplasm, for example, ganglioglioma. Ganglioglioma is a low-grade lesion, WHO1. Typically, it does present in the temporal lobe. However, you should see enhancing component. Sometimes it's solidly enhancing, like in this case. Cystic lesion with enhancing mirror nodule. And it's one of those lesions that does calcify. If you see a calcified lesion with a cystic lesion with enhancing mirror nodule, you can consider ganglioglioma over, for example, pilocytic astrocytoma, which is another lesion that like to show cystic component with an enhancing mirror nodule. Choice D, cystic encephalomalacia. The dilatation may be due to prior infarction. However, it would be very strange for all infarction to show no signs of gliosis at all. So this does not make a lot of sense for cystic encephalomalacia. Also, if you look at the coronal view, you will appreciate the typical location for choroidal fissure cyst. Rather than seeing volume loss, there's a mass effect. So this is not due to all infarction. Mesiotemporal sclerosis. Based on the history of seizure, you do want to look for mesiotemporal sclerosis. At the first glance, some people may mistake this as a dilated temporal horn. However, for mesiotemporal sclerosis, you should see at least 2 out of 3 findings, which is abnormal signal intensity, especially on flare, atrophy of the hippocampus compared to this normal healthy sign. You can see clear atrophy, often leading into the ex vacuo dilatation of the temporal horn. And you can also see that loss of internal architecture. Let's look at this case right here, our case. Even though at first glance you may mistaken this as a dilated temporal horn, however, you should appreciate that the hippocampus, while it's being compressed, it does not have an asymmetric signal compared to the other side. Also, you can see the hippocampus still remains a normal volume, there's no atrophy, and there's a preserved internal architecture. So this is not mesotemporal sclerosis. So the best answer here is choroidal fissure cyst. Choroidal fissure cyst is important to recognize because you don't want to mistaken it as some other more concerning lesion, such as neoplasm, and leading into an unnecessary follow-up or worse, an unnecessary biopsy. That's all for this brain case number 10. Good luck on your board exam. Thank you.